the thinking of Teilhard was the idea that evolution is not completely a passive a trend, but it is something that there are choices there. And he had the idea that even some species somehow they do a kind of choices, moral choices somehow, if we can speak like that, and that some choices will bring toward a greater complexity of life, but some choices will bring some species to a kind of a dead end. And today, because for the first time, for Teilhard de Chardin, humanity has this awareness of being so much interdependent. And so that again, we are led to make a choice. What are we going to do with that? Are we going to accept this interdependence, this higher degree of complexity, which has to go also with a higher intensity of internal consciousness in each individual, or are we going to refuse and to reject this kind of interdependence and to fall back into perhaps a lower form of life and complexity and consciousness? It is a kind of wisdom, I should say, is a kind of optimism, but it's not this kind of optimism which is very superficial, but it is a true optimism which is able to see how we are situated in history at one point of the time, but at the same time to understand that even though our position in history is very limited, but we still, each one of us, we can have a positive contribution. And so Teilhard de Chardin was very much aware of all the forces of opposition, of destruction in the world. But he really had such confidence on the power of the mind that each one of us, we can be awakened and to understand that yes, we can have a positive action on this world. So I think that probably it is the message, I should say, of Teilhard for the world today.